There are the ones who don't know about Malaysia. They don't know. And there are the ones who heard about Malaysia sometime in the past, how it recovered from the 1997 crisis. They heard about Dr. Mahathir Mohamad. They heard about Malaysia's beaches and food. And then there's the third type, the people who know Malaysia or who want to know Malaysia and who would invest their time in Malaysia. And I hope I can categorize myself in the last section. Just to share with you a quick story, at the University of Michigan, I used to organize a lot of events to involve Arab Americans in the political process. And one of my arch rivals was Jacob Shribman. So he was part of the American-Israeli Student Association. So every time I'd organize an event and invite speakers from the American from the Democratic Party, the Republican Party, he would talk to me and retaliate, "Salim, I will get you back, and look what I'm organized the next day." And he would indeed organize big events with a series of wonderful speakers. And so one day I went to him, to Jacob, and I said, "Jacob, what does Israel represent to you? You're not Israeli, you're not Jewish, and you don't speak Hebrew. What is it?" He looked at me and he said, "Frankly, should things hit the fan in the US or Europe, I have a place I can call home without being part of it necessarily." And I only understood what he meant when I moved to Malaysia. And ironically, Malaysia represents to me what Israel represents to Jacob. So today, the people who are sitting here, you are Malaysia's future. You are Malaysia's new chapter. And please inspire us. I want to let you know that the decisions made in Malaysia reach far beyond its shores. So I invite everyone here to keep in mind that the decisions made influence a lot more than only Malaysians. So please let me, ladies and gentlemen, introduce Wan Muhammad Firdaus, the founding chairman of Young Corporate Malaysians, to deliver his speech. Thank you.